In this example, this figure shows a conducting loop of which the semicircular part lies in the magnetic induction B. We can see this is an outward direction, which varies with the time given as AT cube plus CT square plus F Tesla. And here the wire is having a resistance capital R ohms per meter. And we are required to find the current in the loop at time 2 seconds. Now in this situation here you can see, when an outward direction magnetic induction is increasing with time, then in this semicircular loop, an EMF is induced which will be clockwise in sense so as to produce a magnetic induction in inward direction to decrease this magnetic induction. So if this EMF induced is E, you can see the direction of current by this EMF is opposing the direction of current produced by the external battery. So here we can directly write induced EMF E in the semicircular part. This can be given as the area multiplied by dV by dt, as here it is time varying magnetic field. And the area in this situation is pi r square by 2, that of a semicircle. And dV by dt from this expression we can write 3at square plus 2ct. Now this EMF is opposing the external battery, so here we can directly write current in loop I. This we can write as battery EMF minus the induced EMF divided by the resistance. Total resistance we can denote it by RT. Now in this situation, this RT we can calculate as here we can separately write total resistance of loop is. In this situation, total resistance RT we can write capital R multiplied by the total length of this loop. And for this total length, we can see in this situation, this length here it is R by 2. So it is R by 2 plus R by 2 plus this 2R is the diametrical length, and the semicircular part we can use as pi R. So in this situation, we can see the total length we are getting is small r capital R. And if we take the remaining terms common, this will be 3 plus pi. Now, on substituting the value of RT over here, we can see the value of current we are getting is E minus pi R square by 2 multiplied by 3AT square plus 2CT divided by small r capital R into 3 plus pi. So, this will be the total current in the loop. That will be the answer to this problem.